The funding we received from the Motor Accident Insurance Commission will allow us to create the next generation of rehabilitation devices for spinal cord injury.
Historically, nothing has been able to restore function in people with spinal cord injury. So these kind of thought-activated therapies with pharmacology and electrical stimulation, we have evidence that it works.
We have a rehabilitation device, a rehabilitation robotics in this case, and we are using a brain-computer interface. We are interpreting that data using artificial intelligence. That data is then sent to a digital twin of the person, which is a personalized digital representation of the person's bones, muscles, joints, and so on. And the digital twin controls the rehabilitation devices. So when you have a spinal cord injury, you can't perceive sensations such as touch, pressure, or understand how your limbs are positioned in space. So the idea is the one of neuroplasticity. We know that we can remap our nervous system, reactivating those existing connections. We are creating an extended reality environment, providing sensory feedback back to the person. So the person is more empowered, feels, you know, has control over the rehabilitation and understand that missing connection is being re-established between the movement that you're doing and actually perceiving it.
To my knowledge, this is the world's first. So we're integrating all these different therapies that have shown to be promising in spinal cord injury, and we're making it better by adding our own personalized digital human. We have such a great group of multidisciplinary expertise, and we're putting all these pieces together to make it a complete working therapy. I think we're really, really, really lucky to have had the support of the Motor Accident Insurance Commission, who have the same passions. And we're at a time, I think, where we can really start to move these things along quickly for the people.